It's AumSum time!
Why are we afraid of the dark?
I'm so cool. I'm not afraid.
Some experts say humans have developed this fear due to evolution. In prehistoric times, our ancestors were at high risk of being attacked by predators or enemies when in dark. Hence, through evolution, the tendency to fear darkness developed. Also, in the dark, as we cannot see properly, it creates anxiety, making us imagine the worst possible outcomes. So, it is not the darkness itself that we find frightening. It is what or who lurks in that darkness. Also, if we observe other people getting afraid, or if we are told to be afraid about something, we immediately accept those things as scary. So, whether it is our parents warning us about the dark, or a horror movie showing a ghost appear in the dark, our brain latches onto it and starts getting afraid of the darkness.
My horse fainted! Somebody help! Just kidding. Horses can sleep lying down. But being massive in size, they wouldn't be able to get up and run from predators. Also, lying down for long restricts blood circulation, putting pressure on their organs. Hence, through evolution, they developed a mechanism called stay apparatus, in which they lock the ligaments and tendons of their legs to avoid falling, thus helping them take small naps while standing.
Oh no! I'm gonna die!
Just kidding! Bananas contain a radioactive isotope of potassium called K40, but it doesn't lead to radiation poisoning. How do I know? Unit to measure radiation exposure is sievert. According to research, radiation exposure should not exceed 50,000 millisieverts annually. Eating a banana exposes us to only 0.1 microsieverts. So, bananas won't cause radiation poisoning unless you eat millions of them at the same time.
Shush! Somebody's talking.
It's the trees! Beneath our feet, thousands of tree roots are connected to one another by fungi, whose roots penetrate and spread into the ground. They form a network called mycorrhizal network, through which trees send chemical signals and talk to each other. Big mother trees, called hubs, send nourishment to smaller plants, helping them grow. Also, a dying tree deposits its resources in the network for other trees to use.